Hello everyone, this is Millie with the Octopars. In the last video, we've talked about how to extract data with the auto-detect algorithm in Octopars 8.1. In this lesson, we'll show you how to optimize your task to get your dream data accurately. Okay, let's get started. Method number one, switch auto-detected data results. When Octopars auto-detects the data on any web page, it screens the web page and fetches one or more data sets using its machine learning algorithm. If the auto-detected data is not your target data, you can switch to the other sets of data by clicking on Switch Auto-Detect Results. Let's take a closer look at the fraction here. It says 1/4. This means that Octopars has detected 4 sets of data and you're looking at the first one. By clicking on this button, you can switch to the other results easily. Method number 2. Build your crawler from scratch. However, if none of the auto-detected results rise to your expectations, you will need to set up the workflow manually. But don't worry, Octopars simulates human interaction with web pages, meaning that it provides you with the ability to conduct web scraping with point and click. If you've never built a crawler from scratch with Octopars before, I highly recommend you give yourself a spin by following the video right here. I've also linked the tutorial in the description box. Feel free to check it out. As different websites vary in layouts and structures, not all data can be accessed instantly. For example, there are websites that would require login credentials, so you'll need to provide your user account to allow Octopars to open a page and scrape the data for you. Or you may need to enter a single term or a list of search phrases first so that Octopars can fetch corresponding search results. Another common scenario is that you need to choose a category from the drop-down menu, which will bring you to a new page. If any of the above-mentioned scenarios is the case, you can follow this step-by-step tutorial to interact with the page. Method number 3. Locate the pagination buttons to extract more pages. To extract data from a number of pages, you need to set up pagination by clicking the page buttons. To do so, you need to click the single next page button or the page numbers. Usually, Octopars will detect the next page button automatically. But if the next page button isn't detected, we've mentioned before how you can troubleshoot this problem. On the other hand, if some websites have pagination bars that display page numbers, you'll need to click through the page numbers to visit respective pages. To do this, you'll need to edit XPath to locate the page numbers. XPath stands for XML Path Language. It can be used to locate data precisely. As we need to keep this video short, I'll skip this part for now. I've attached a tutorial about how to handle pagination with page numbers below. Method number 4. Scroll down the page multiple times to load more data. For lengthy websites, data can only be scraped successfully after the page gets fully loaded. In order to get more data displayed, we need to scroll down the page. Usually, Octopars automatically scrolls down the page when a web page is loaded in the built-in browser. You can easily edit the number of scroll times to control the amount of content that it will display. Method number 5. Edit the workflow. Now let's go to our beautiful workflow. To understand the meaning of a workflow is the key to successfully building a crawler. A workflow demonstrates the whole extraction process, with each step representing the corresponding process. No matter if Octopars generated a workflow automatically or you built a workflow manually, you can edit a workflow to ensure the task does what you tell it to do. Each step has various settings that you can modify and fine-tune your scraping task. 1. Rearrange the steps of the workflow by single drag and drop. In most cases, in order to make the workflow work properly, the loop item should be inside the pagination loop, is the bot needs to finish scraping all the items within the current page before proceeding to the following pages. However, if the auto-generated workflow shows up like this, you can always drag it back inside to repair the workflow. And that looks much better now. 2. Add steps to the workflow. If you want to add more actions to the workflow, simply place the mouse in between till a little plus sign shows up. As you can see, Octoparse provides multiple options, which gives you the ability to add in more advanced crawlers to deal with complex websites. 3. Rename, copy, or delete steps. When building a workflow, you may make mistakes and want to undo the action. This can be done easily with Octoparse, as you can rename, open, copy, paste, and delete any steps by clicking the ellipsis icon. 4. Hover over and check general settings of each step. You can easily check the settings of each step by hovering your cursor over the workflow. For instance, you can check the URL of the current web page, the wait time before each step, the data to be extracted, so on and so forth. 5. Modify detailed settings of each step. Last but not least, after checking the general settings of each step, if you want to make further changes on the details, simply click on the settings icon and you will find various options. And now, you can roll up your sleeves to edit the detailed settings of each step as the way you want them to be. And that's all for lesson 2. Would you give a thumbs up if you find this video useful? If you have any questions, don't hesitate to email us at support@octoparse.com. To know how to reformat your data, you can check out Lesson 3.